I welcome you all on this joyful occasion and greet you in the name of the Lord. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. God of all grace, you call your church to be a holy people to the praise of your name. In the power of your Spirit, fill our hearts with your love and our lives with your glory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple. Seraphs were in attendance above him. Each had six wings. With two they covered their faces, and with two they covered their feet, and with two they flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The pivots on the threshold shook at the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me, I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said, "Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt has departed and your sin is blotted out." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send and who will go for us?" And I said, "Here am I, send me."
Second reading is from Romans chapter 12, verse 1 to 18, and I read in Kinyarwanda from Rwanda. Bavandimwe, kubera ko Imana yabahaye imbabazi, ndabihanangiriza ngo mwitange, maze mube ibitambo bizima byeguriwe Imana biyishimisha, uko niko kuyikorera kubakwiriye. Ntimugakurikize imibereho y'ab'iki gihe, ahubwo murebe, mureke Imana ivugurure ibitekerezo byanyu, mube muhindutse rwose, nibwo muzashobora kumenya neza iby'Imana ishaka, kugira ngo muhitemo ibyiza bishimishije kandi bitunganye rwose. Kubera ubuntu Imana yabagiriye, ndabwira buri wese muri mwe, nti uramenye we kwitekerezaho birenze urugero uriho, ahubwo ushyire mu gaciro, wiyoroheje, ukurikije urugero Imana yaguhaye rwo kuyizera. Buri muntu muri mwe afite umubiri umwe ugizwe n'ingingo nyinshi, kandi izo ngingo ntizigira umubiri, ntizigira umurimo umwe. Uko niko nubwo turi benshi muri Kristo, twabaye umuntu umwe, twese duhurijwe hamwe, buri muntu akaba urugingo rwa mugenzi we. Dufite kandi impano zitandukanye Imana yatugabiye, yagabiye buri wese. Wahawe guhanura ngo avuge ibyo yeretswe, nakoresha iyo mpano ashingiye ku kwizera yahawe. Wahawe impano yo gukoresha abandi, ngaho nabikore. Wahawe yo kwigisha, niyigishe. Wahawe yo gukomeza abantu imitima, nabakomeze. Utanga kubye, natange atitangiriye itama. Uyobora abandi, nabikorana umwete. Nugiriye undi impuhwe, nazigire yishimye. Mujye mukundana mutaryaryana, mwange ikibi cyose, mwibande ku byiza, mukundane urukundo rwa kivandimwe, mwubahane, buri muntu ashyire mugenzi we imbere, mugire umwete, mwe kuba abanyabute, mukorere Nyagasani mufite ishyaka ryinshi, mwishimire ibyo mwiringiye, mwihangane mu makuba, ntimucogore mu gusenga. Intore z'Imana zikennye, muzifashishe ku byo mufite, nizibasanga muzicumbikire. Musabire umugisha abatoteza, koko mubasabire umugisha atari umuvumo. Mwishimane n'abishimye, murirane n'abarira, mubane muhuje. Mwe kwishyira hejuru, ahubwo mwemere gukora imirimo yoroheje, ntimukigire abanyabwenge. Nimwituro umuntu nabi yabagiriye, muharanire gukora ibigaragarira abantu bose ko ari byiza, uko bizashoboka kose mu ruhande rwanyu, mubane amahoro n'abantu bose. Amen.
To John. Hear the gospel of Christ.
Glory to Christ.
The gospel reading is John chapter 20, verse 19 to 29. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fears of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands and put my finger in the mark of the nails and my hands in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to Christ our Lord.
Let us pray. Loving God, quicken our hearts again, that we may receive your word afresh and anew. Send the refreshing wind of your spirit upon us, Lord, that your voice may be heard in our hearts and your loving presence seen in all that we say and do. And from the written word, by the spoken word, help us to encounter the living word. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. As I preach this afternoon and open God's word, I hope there is something in what I say for everyone. We are all, I am sure, recognize that by our presence, we are witnesses to a profound, never-to-be-repeated moment in the lives of our ordinands. But of course, I do speak to Ian and Julie, to Sydney Samuel, to Margaret, to Ken, to Katie, to Becky, to Yan Yan, and to Sue. But we all listen in. Well, you can go to sleep if you like. But I hope that if you do listen in, you take home something of ourselves as we've sensed God's presence, as we've sensed his peace, his shalom. A few years ago, I sat on St. Pancras Station drinking a decaf coffee, waiting for my train. And across from me, there used to be, where I was sat, a flower shop. And there was two rows of 10 very large yucca plants. The sign said, "Special offer, half price." And as I sat, I wondered to myself, if you're coming and going in a station as busy as St. Pancras, who would want to travel with a huge yucca plant? They were big enough to take up their own seat. They were cumbersome and almost ungainly. And how would you carry one with your suitcase and a yucca and negotiate the escalator? I was not surprised they were on special offer. But for weeks after, I wondered about the yucca plants. I wondered if in the end they'd been recycled as compost. I wondered about them. The yucca got me thinking about the church, as so many in our society today see the church as irrelevant, cumbersome in our bureaucracy. People don't travel with us like they used to. They don't want to be part of us. They don't relate to us or the gospel. Yet, as I sat drinking my coffee, I really wanted to take a yucca home. But inevitably, it was all about context. And for me, traveling that day in St. Pancras, as I watched the people go by, the yucca had no real relevance. But I really wanted them to be relevant, wanted the 10 to be taken home, to find a home. I wanted them to feel loved and valued. Today, that is what I want for you too, as ordinands, now received into full connection, all shiny and new, and ready to have hands laid upon you and to be ordained. You are of value to the church, infinitely precious to God. You are very much loved and valued by your family and your friends, your members who have gathered here today, but also by the church. But in these days of a world pandemic not yet over, and for a long time we won't be post-COVID, what does the church mean for us, its people, its presbyters, deacons, disciples, Methodist people? How can each of us make our contribution so that no one feels out of place, no one feels unwanted and alone, no one feels isolated and unloved? And in trying to answer my questions, I turn to John's Gospel and the encounter of Jesus with his disciples and those words, "Peace be with you." Those words such rich in imagery, shalom, words that go to the heart of our very being. It's that peace, that shalom, what the church is about today. Do we offer that peace, that shalom? And if that's not what we're about, and for you as ordinance, but all of us as people today, both lay and ordained, the Church of Christ, what is it that we offer if we're not offering peace to the world? Recognizing, of course, that it will look very different in every place, because, of course, context matters. You will have noticed in the passage that Jesus offered that sign of peace to his disciples, he does it three times. I had not noticed that before. Do you sometimes pick your Bible up and wonder if the passage you're reading was there last time you read it? Peace be with you. Three times Jesus offers to his disciples. First in greeting them as he entered the room. Then on the second occasion, he offers a sort of rider, only then after they've seen his hands and his side, and they rejoiced. The recognition of who it was that was standing before them. Their beloved Jesus, the person who they'd travelled with, lived with, learned so much from, there he was offering them peace. And they rejoiced in the and in the same circumstances, we would have done the same. And isn't this just one of those occasions when you really wanted to be there? I know that I would. But then, on that second occasion, comes the rider, the clincher for the disciples. Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. And then he breathed on them and said, receive the Holy Spirit. Jesus is saying very clearly, this peace is to be shared. I'm sending you out in the power of the Spirit to spread this peace around. And then a third time in the passage, peace is offered. Again, a week later, when Thomas is present. We don't know why he wasn't present earlier. And Jesus uses exactly the same words, peace be with you. So not a one-off event, not a sort of normal greeting, almost a command. Spread my peace and believe. And even though we may never have heard it or seen it personally for ourselves, there's a resonance there for us, because this, for Thomas and for us, is about real deep faith. The commentators say of this passage, it forms our doctrine of ministry. And that ministry is not just about the ordained, it's for all of us as disciples of Christ. So today, how are we offering that peace, that shalom to those around us? This is not just hello, not just nice to see you, come on in, as we would greet those who came to visit. This is much more profound words for mission to the world. And how are we offering that profound truth, that mission, that peace, that shalom? My Sunday school teacher died a few weeks ago, just 2 weeks short of her 93rd birthday. A daughter-in-law had informed me that she'd gone into a nursing home, having lived on her own till just a few weeks earlier when she'd had a fall. Knowing I was moving to the southwest from the Midlands, I travelled to the northwest to see her. I entered the nursing home and was shown into a little room with the usual attire now of gloves and apron and mask, wondering if she would recognise me. But she did, and she smiled, and I said, it's Lorraine, and she said, I know. And now you have come, you can pray. I want some peace. Tell God to take me now, because he'll listen to you. Well, I said the usual platitudes. Well, you know, Mrs. Rowe, didn't dare call her Nelly. Well, you know, Mrs. Rowe, I will pray with you, but it's really God's timing. Shall I pray he'll ease your pain and pray for healing? No, no, she said. I want peace. I want to go now. In this moment, as I was trying to form the prayers she so obviously wanted, that God would take her and that she would receive that peace in death, my thoughts went to the covenant service. Christ has many services to be done. Some are easy, others are difficult. Some bring honour, others bring reproach. Some are suitable to our inclinations and material interests. Others are contrary to both. In some, we may please Christ and please ourselves. In other words, we cannot please Christ except by denying ourselves. And as the prayer that I never wanted to pray formed in my mind, and as I sat with a person who'd had immense influence in my life, other words came to mind, words that we will hear in a few minutes. In all things, give counsel and encouragement to those who Christ entrusts in your care. Pray without ceasing. Work with joy in the Lord's service. Let no one suffer through your neglect. This ministry will make great demands on you and upon those close to you. Yet in all of this, the Holy Spirit will sustain you by his grace. She died the next day, and I was told, completely at peace with a smile on her face. And as ordinands, you will have all too experienced similar circumstances. You will have been sustained by the Holy Spirit. And those situations may well have confirmed the call of God on your life. And we give thanks for that call and that commitment and that dedication to God, which is why we're able to say with gusto in a few minutes' time, you are worthy, but please believe it because you are. In our reading from John's Gospel, Jesus was confirming in one of what we know as his resurrection appearances that the disciples were worthy. This is an encounter with the living Christ, and today we can too encounter that living Christ, as that is where faith is born and grows and matures, that encounter with the living Christ. That encounter with Jesus meant for the disciples they had to go into the world and offer that same peace, embody that peace, be in mission. We talk, don't we, about doing mission. We talk of going on mission. But this text is saying, be mission. You are my disciples. I have breathed on you. Now go and be my peace, my shalom. It's taken me an awful long time to get it. But in that moment with my Sunday school teacher, I had to be the mission to her and to pray a prayer I didn't want to pray and offer something I didn't want to offer. Yes, of course, I wanted to offer peace, but not at the expense of her life. Jesus, in this passage in John, also points us to God, who is the missionary God, who is defined as the sender, Jesus described as the sent one. So our mission, our DNA, reaches back to the Trinity as Jesus breathes on his disciples and breathes on us and on you as ordinands today. Not to receive it once, but to continue to remember that the Holy Spirit is there for us all at all times. And your call is not a once-in-a-lifetime experience, but an ongoing developing call which changes and challenges, which brings joy and delight, and also powerful experiences as you are mission to the world. At the inauguration of Bishop Biden, many of us were surprised by the words of Amanda Gorman, who said this: "And yes, we are far from polished, far from pristine, but this does not mean we are striving to form a union that is perfect. We are serving to forge our union with purpose, to compose a country committed to all cultures, colours, and characters and conditions of all people. And so we lift our gazes not to what stands between us, but who stands before us. We close the divide because we know we put our future first. We must first put our differences aside. We lay down our arms so that we can reach out our arms to one another. We seek human harm to no one and harmony for all. This is mission. We mission to that peace, that shalom, as individuals, disciples, and as church." So my prayer today on this auspicious, wonderful occasion, when you, Ian and Julie and Sydney Samuel and Margaret and Ken and Katie and Becky and Yan Yan and Sue are ordained in the Church of God, I pray that the church in your future is not like the yucca, sat alone where no one wants them and left to languish on the sidelines of a busy world. We must be mission. We must be peace. We must be that shalom. And we must be loving and caring, be socially aware, tuned into God's vision for our churches and our people. We must be people of peace and people of prayer and shalom, as that's what makes us human under God, and why so many people may see God's image in us and see and experience his shalom. God bless you all, Ordinance, today. You are worthy. And may you know God's shalom in Jesus' name through the power of his Spirit. Be mission. Amen.
Let us profess the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Mr. President, I present to you these persons to be ordained presbyters. The conference has received them into full connection and resolved that they be ordained by prayer and the laying on of hands. Susan Joan Baker Maha, Yan Yan Case, Ian Richard Couchman, Julie King, Sydney Samuel Lake, Kenneth George McNally, Margaret Newman, Catherine Jane Smith, Rebecca Helen Wright.
Would you turn around? Sisters and brothers in Christ, these are the persons whom we intend, in God's name, to ordain to the ministry of Christ's Holy Church in the order of presbyters. Their call has been tested in preparation for this ministry, and they have been found to be of sound learning and faithful to their vocation. We ask you to declare your assent to their ordination. Do you believe and trust that they are, by God's grace, worthy to be ordained?
They are worthy.
Will you uphold them in their ministry?
We will uphold them.
Thank you. Beloved in Christ, the Church is God's holy people, the body of Christ, the dwelling place of the Holy Spirit. All who are received into the Church by baptism are called to proclaim the mighty acts of God in Jesus Christ our Saviour, and to serve Him in the Church and in the world. God has called you into the order of presbyters among his people. In his name, you are to preach by word and deed the gospel of God's grace, to declare God's forgiveness of sin, to declare God's forgiveness of sins to all who are penitent, to baptize, to confirm, and to preside at the celebration of the sacrament of Christ's body and blood, to lead God's people in worship, prayer, and service, to minister Christ's love and compassion, to serve others in whom you serve the Lord Himself. These things are your common duty and delight. In them you are to watch over one another in love. In all things, give counsel and encouragement, and give it to those whom Christ entrusts to your care. Pray without ceasing. Work with joy in the Lord's service. Let no one suffer hurt through your neglect. This ministry will make great demands upon you and upon those close to you. Yet in all this, the Holy Spirit will sustain you by His grace. I now ask you to declare your lifelong commitment to this ministry. Do you believe that God has called you to be a minister of the Word and sacraments in the Universal Church? Do you accept the Holy Scriptures as revealing all things necessary for salvation through Jesus Christ our Lord?
I do.
Do you believe the doctrines of the Christian faith as this church has received them?
I do.
Will you accept our discipline and work together with your sisters and brothers in the church?
Amen.
Will you be faithful in worship, in prayer, in the reading of the Holy Scriptures, and in those studies which will equip you for this ministry?
Amen.
May God, who has called you to this ministry, give you grace and power to do His will, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray. On the peoples of the world and the leaders of the nations, gracious God, on your holy church throughout the world, gracious God, on all whom you have called to be ordained, gracious God, on all whom they serve in their ministry, gracious God, on their families and friends, and all who have helped and encouraged them, gracious God. Remember, O Lord, what you have wrought in us, and not what we deserve. And as you have called us to your service, make us worthy of our calling, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Lord our God, we give you thanks and praise. You are the light and life of your people in every age, calling us to declare your acts of mercy and love. You sent your Son Jesus Christ to be our Saviour. He called the apostles to witness to his words and deeds, his life, death, and resurrection. Through him, you have made your church a royal priesthood for the glory of your name. In the power of the Holy Spirit, you strengthen and shepherd your people by sending apostles and prophets, pastors, evangelists, and teachers in a succession of truth and grace. By the same Spirit, you have called these your servants to be ministers in your church. Increase in them the gifts of your grace for their life and ministry. Father, send the Holy Spirit upon Sue for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Amen. Father, send the Holy Spirit upon Yan Yan for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Amen. Father, send the Holy Spirit upon Ian for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Amen. Father, send the Holy Spirit upon Julie for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Amen. Father, send the Holy Spirit upon Sydney Samuel for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Amen. Father, send the Holy Spirit upon Ken for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Amen. Father, send the Holy Spirit upon Margaret for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Amen. Father, send the Holy Spirit upon Katie for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Amen. Father, send the Holy Spirit upon Becky for the office and work of a presbyter in your church. Amen. Gracious God, as you call and ordain these your servants to this ministry, we ask you to fulfill in them the work you have begun. Grant them unfailing love for those people among whom you appoint them as pastors and teachers. May they boldly proclaim your truth and faithfully celebrate your sacraments. Give them wisdom and patience in their witness and service. Sustain and strengthen them at all times, giving faith and perseverance to all who believe in you through their word. May they be counted worthy at the last to enter into the joy of their Lord. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We say together the prayer that Jesus gave us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Receive this Bible as a sign of the authority committed to you this day to preach the word of God and to celebrate the sacraments. Yan Yan, receive this Bible as a sign of the authority committed to you this day to preach the word of God and to celebrate the sacraments. Ian, receive this Bible as a sign of authority committed to you this day to preach the word of God and to celebrate the sacraments. Julie, receive this Bible as a sign of the authority committed to you this day to preach the word of God and to celebrate the sacraments. Sydney Samuel, receive this Bible as a sign of the authority committed to you this day to preach the word of God and to celebrate the sacraments. Ken. Receive this Bible as a sign of authority committed to you, to this day to preach the word of God and to celebrate the sacraments. Margaret, receive this Bible as a sign of authority committed to you, this day to preach the word of God and to celebrate the sacrament. Katie, receive this Bible as a sign of the authority committed to you, this day to preach the word of God and to celebrate the sacraments. Becky, receive this Bible as a sign of authority committed to you, this day to preach the word of God and to celebrate the sacraments.
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I declare that you have been ordained as presbyters of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church of God. Just to be sure, that's the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church of God. Remember your call. Declare the good news. Celebrate the sacraments. Serve the needy. Minister to the sick. Welcome the stranger. Seek the lost. Be shepherds of the flock of Christ. As you exercise mercy, do not forget justice. As you minister discipline, do not forget mercy. Such that when Christ, the chief shepherd, comes in glory, he may count you among his faithful servants. To God be the glory forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. I invite you in a COVID-secure way to share signs of peace with your neighbors. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Thank you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Lord our God, gracious and holy, your power sustains all creation. In love, you create all things, and in mercy, you redeem them. From age to age, you gather a people to serve you, to proclaim your glory, and to reveal your presence in all the world. In the fullness of time, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, the true shepherd of your people. In him, we see your face and hear your word. In compassion, he restored us and made us whole, laying down his life upon the cross and freely offering himself for all. You did not leave him in death, but raised him by your mighty power to make all things new. Through him you sent the Holy Spirit to lead your people into all truth, calling from among us pastors and preachers and teachers of your word. With them and all your people on earth and in heaven, we join the ceaseless song of praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Father, we give you praise as we call to mind how, at supper with his disciples, your Son, Jesus Christ, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup. He gave you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, recalling Christ's offering of himself and celebrating this feast of our redemption, we offer ourselves to you through Christ, our great high priest. Send your Holy Spirit, that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us the body and blood of Christ. Remember, Lord, your church throughout the world. Send your Spirit upon us. Gather us into unity. Strengthen our faith and sustain our hope. Bring us with all who place their hope in you to the promised feast in your kingdom, where forever we may offer you our praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom, with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Christ is the true bread from heaven.
Christ is life to the world.
Christ. One in Christ.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord our God, strengthen the hands that have received these holy gifts, that we may faithfully serve you all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.